It's St. Patrick's Day. For all things Halloween, this is Hauntformer, and everyone, happy St. Patrick's Day. In order to celebrate this momentous holiday, we are going to be continuing my annual Leprechaun movie review series, and I've covered Leprechauns 1, 2, and 3, and now we have finally approached Leprechaun 4 in space. So I think the name, the title, really says it all. Leprechaun 4 in space. There are those rare horror occurrences. It always seems to be horror films for some reason, where after so many movies, they have nothing else to do but to send the title character in space. We saw this with Jason X, and here we are with Leprechaun. After only 4 films, mind you, the Indiana Jones series has 4 films, we get the Leprechaun going to space in order to kidnap and marry this space alien princess in order for the Leprechaun to become king of the universe, to have all of the power and money. That is essentially the plot of this film, though the movie is... So how the Leprechaun series kind of works is the first film tried to be a legit horror comedy. And the second one, too. The third one dabbles much more in comedy, but I really do enjoy it, and a lot of the comedy sticks for me. The fourth one is mostly a parody film. There's not really much horror in this at all. In fact, it feels like a slapstick comedy in many cases. It has similar beats to movies like Aliens, and I'm sure a few others. Also, The Fly is kind of dominated in this film. It really harkens back to those 80s... you know, horror films, even though this was made in the 90s. So I'm not really sure of what happened in this movie, but all I can say is it is a colossal something. It's a colossal something. And I don't want to say it's horrible, because it's almost one of those it's so bad that it's good movies. So I don't want to ruin it for you guys who haven't seen it, because it is a sight to behold. There are scenes in this movie that I can't even explain. There's a scene where the Leprechaun becomes giant.
What did you shoot him with? Steroids?
And the effects are just mind-boggling, really. There's also a scene where the main army sergeant dresses up in drag because he was too manly earlier.
This should be a darling floor show.
There's also a scene where a sergeant pees on the leprechaun's corpse, and then the leprechaun travels into his penis and comes out of the guy's body later on in the movie, kind of like an alien. I have no words for Leprechaun 4 in space. Really, what I can say is, if you haven't seen it and you are a fan of the Leprechaun series, just see it this St. Patrick's Day. You'll be sure to get a laugh in. If you're looking for at least a legit good Leprechaun movie, go back and watch the other three, because this one is far from anything horrific. In fact, the most horrible thing about this movie, the most horrifying thing, is that the movie even exists. But I'm not gonna trash it too much, because like I said, it is one of those so bad that it's good movies, but it almost is pushing it so much where it's not even that. Man, Leprechaun 4 just broke me. I've been broken on St. Patrick's Day. And the scientist robot who roams around and then he turns into a spider. I don't even know.
All right. Big is good.
One of the only things that really helps this movie is Warwick Davis and his performance. His presence in the movie automatically makes it better, because in all of these Leprechaun movies, whether they're good or bad, he shines because he is just into this character and you have to respect him for that. So Warwick Davis, you're awesome, and the Leprechaun continues to live on. Overall, I'm going to give Leprechaun 4 in Space a 1.5 out of 5 skulls on the RIP Reviews rating scale, because they did put some effort into the movie. They did have some interesting set design with some of the space locations, even though the special effects were pretty bad. But, you know, at least they tried, and it was kind of entertaining because it was so outlandish. So for that reason, I'm going to say overall I did think it's somewhat redeemable by those qualities. But really, if you want an authentic movie to watch for St. Patrick's Day, go out and see some of the other Leprechaun horror films. It'll do you much better. Thank you for watching this review. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you enjoy your St. Patrick's Day festivities. Remember, as always, for all things Halloween, this is Hauntformer, and I want me gold.